हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम समद। आई एम गोइंग टू सॉल्व गेट एरोस्पेस एयरक्राफ्ट स्ट्रक्चर क्वेश्चंस व्हिच आस्क इन 2018 एंड दिस पेपर हैड बीन ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय आईआईटी गुवाहाटी। सो हियर इज द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन। डिटरमाइन द करेक्टनेस और अदरवाइज ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स। सो दे आर टू स्टेटमेंट इज गिवन, ए एंड आर, एंड फोर ऑप्शन इज गिवन। सो फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट इज अ क्लोज सेक्शन बॉक्स बीम कॉन्फिगुरेशन इज यूज इन एयरक्राफ्ट विंग्स। ओके, यस इट इज यूज। Closed section box beam configuration is capable of resisting torsional loads. Resisting torsional loads coming due to aerodynamic forces. Yes, it is also right. So first option and first statement and second statement both are right. Okay. So according to this, we have A is the right option. Okay. A and R are true and R is the correctness reasons for A. Because aircraft wing is closed section box beam configuration which is capable of resisting torsional loads. Okay, solid circular shaft of diameter D is under pure torsion of magnitude T. The maximum tensile stress experienced at any point on this shaft is. So this question is based on formulas. Okay, so as we know that tau by r is equal to t by j, this is the governing equation. So we can write tau is equal to t by j into r, we can write d by 2. Okay, so as we know that j is the polar moment of inertia, so we can write tau. Okay, actually we have to take formula from the maximum tensile stress. Okay, so tau is the maximum tensile stress. Tau is equal to, okay, T, and J is the actually pi by 32 into D to the power 4 into D by 2. So after solving this, finally we will get 16 T divided by pi DQ. Okay, this is the formula. Best we have to remember this formula also. So according to this, we have a solution T by pi dq, that is D is the right option. Okay, climbed beam subjected to a point load P at the mid span is shown in the figure below. The magnitude of the moment reaction at the two fixed ends of the beam is. So actually this is the climbed beam, that is fixed both side fixed. So first of all, we have to find out R1. Just assume this is R1, okay, and this is R2. So using force equilibrium, we will get R1 plus R2 is equal to only one load is there is P. And using moment equilibrium, we have this is the area. Actually, if we find this moment diagram, so we will get the one area that is like that. Okay, how we will get like that? Because this is the equilibrium and this point P is acted on center, so we will get R1 is equal to R2, which is equal to P by 2. Okay, so this is the moment diagram area. Okay, if we get the area of this, so we will get 1 by 2 into P L by 4 into L plus MB. As you know that maximum for fix maximum moment is P L by 4. Okay, so and now MB into L, which is equal to 0. Directly if we solve this one, okay, MB equal to minus P L square by 8. So finally we get MB is equal to PL by 8. MB, that is equal to MA. Okay, so this is the point mid distance on the figure, the magnitude of the moment direction at the two fixed ends. So just we have considered MA, so just consider MA here and MB here. Okay, so MA equal to MB is equal to PL by 8. According to this, C is the right option. Okay. So using reaction, we can already take the P by 2, P by 2. This is the reaction, and using this maximum moment is PL by 4. We have taken the area. Okay, 1 by 2 PL by 4 into L. Okay, this area plus MB into L. Okay, that is MB this one and this one L. Okay. From this to this end, okay. So finally we got a PL by 8. This is equal to MA equal to MB. Next question is, a thin wall tube with external radius of 100 mm and wall thickness of 2 mm is fixed at one end. It is subjected to a compressive force of 1 Newton acting at a point on the circumference parallel to its length. The maximum normal stress experienced by the structure is. So we have to find out maximum normal stress. Okay, so how can we solve this question? Actually, thin wall, this is a thin wall tube and external radius is given, it is R is equal to 100 mm, okay, which is equal to 0.1 meter, and inner radius R is equal to 100 minus T, okay, which is equal to 100 minus 2, that is 98 mm, which is equal to 0.098 meter. So meter, okay. Actually we have a R is equal to R minus T, that is R equal to R plus T. Okay, using this we got R equal a small r, that is inner radius is 100 minus T. Okay, we have compressive force, that is F equal to 1 newton. Okay, so maximum normal stress, we have formula, maximum normal stress is equal to F divided by pi, that is area. Okay, pi r square F by a, that is area is pi r square minus small r square. Okay, because this is a wall tube, okay, so we got area as pi into capital R square minus a small r square. Okay, and this is compressive, you know, this is compressive force. Okay, so compressive force means minus, we will apply minus. So after solving this, that is minus 1 newton divided by pi. Okay, capital R square means 0.1 square minus a small r square, that is 0.098 square. Okay, okay, this is the maximum normal stress. So after solving this, we got a maximum normal stress is equal to minus 0.803, okay, in kilopascal. Okay, so we have to write in kilopascal. So we got in kilopascal, that is minus 0.803. okay. Next question is, a cantilever beam having a rectangular cross section of width 60 mm and depth is given 100 mm, and the material mechanical properties Young's modulus is given, ultimate stress is given, assume factor of safety also given. Okay, so the maximum bending moment that can be applied on the beam is. So we have to find out maximum bending moment. Okay, as we know that maximum stress is equal to sigma by 4. Okay, because this is a factor of safety formula, factor of safety is equal to sigma for allowable, sigma for working. Okay, so sigma for working or maximum stress is sigma for allowable divided by 4. So sigma ultimate, okay, ultimate or allowable, we have 480 divided by 4. So we got 120 megapascal. Okay, that is if we write 120 mega newton per mm square. So maximum moment is M is equal to sigma maximum divided by y into I. This is the formula. So we have 120, okay, 120 megapascal, and y is given, okay, depth is given 100 mm. So we will write a 100 by 2, okay, into I.
So how to find out I, that is B H Q by 12. I is equal to 4 rectangular B H Q by 12. So we'll write B is 60, H is 100, which is equal to Q. B H Q divided by 12. Okay, so after solving this, we will get 12. Okay. 12 into 10 to the power 6 newton mm, because we have everything is in mm, 120 mm. So 120 mega pascal is equal to 120 newton per mm square also. Okay, so after solving this, finally if we convert the unit, okay, so mm to mm to meter, so we got 12 kilo newton meter. Now we'll see the next question. The components of a stress in a body under plane stress condition in this absence of the body force is given by sigma xx, sigma yy, and sigma xy is given. So as such that the coefficient A such that the body is under equilibrium. Okay, so for the equilibrium equation, we have dou sigma xx divided by dou x plus dou sigma xy divided by dou y is equal to 0. Okay, so if we differentiate in a sigma xx, we got 2ax plus, if we differentiate sigma xy, that is this one, with respect to y, so we got plus 12x. Okay, is equal to 0. So after solving this, we got a equal to minus 6. Okay, so a equal to minus 6 is the right answer. Okay, accurate to one decimal, so there is no decimal, we have to put only zeros, minus 6.0. okay.